What makes HAL Tejas so reliable in an open war? Hi, I'm Archita and welcome back to this new video where we are going to discuss about the reliability and the traits of HAL Tejas. So, let's get into it. During the recent Ganga Shakti exercise conducted by the Indian Army and Indian Air Force in the early part of this year, HAL Tejas has already proved its mettle and showed how reliable it is. IAF developed its 8 Tejas fighter aircrafts, out of which 6 were able to go over 6 sorties per day, which speaks volume about the capability of this platform. The key to the high serviceability of Tejas compared to other IAF assets is due to the fact that the prime assets of IAF like Su-30 MKI make heavy use of electric hydraulic system, which needs regular updating and checks and even servicing for several hours to keep them combat ready. LCA Tejas, on the other hand, utilizes internal monitoring system which can diagnose system faults through plug-in teasers. This makes Tejas much more simplified than Su-30 MKI or any other aircraft in IAF in terms of serviceability and maintainability. LCA Tejas showed some minor technical faults due to climate change, which was fixed up within few hours, all thanks to the readily available HAL engineers and technicians. LCA Tejas underwent the tough, rigorous of simulated real-life combat, performing almost 504 sorties in total during the whole exercise. Sorties as small as 30 minutes to as large as 1.5 hours were performed, which showed the endurance capacity of LCA Tejas as a platform and also exhibited its ground attack, air defense and strike mission capabilities. IAF is already looking to tap the capabilities of using a combo of a heavyweight air dominance fighter and a lightweight fighter in offensive as well as in a defensive nature, where Su-30 MKI can perform in the role of a mini ox, all thanks to its powerful BARS radar and its net-centric capabilities, which enable many features such as buddy firing mode, target identification, localization and more. In a real-life combat, IAF can deploy in more Tejas with greater serviceability than any other combat aircraft, thanks to the easy availability of spare parts and servicing from HAL due to an easy ecosystem for Tejas developing in India. The long and painful development period of LCA Tejas has borne in many results. And further Indian projects like Aura and MCA will capitalize on this newly formed ecosystem. Let's suppose Tejas is now deployed for a high altitude strike mission. High altitude flying is the biggest ban for any fighter pilot. However, Tejas has already demonstrated flawless high altitude flying. 2 Tejas can be deployed with 4 laser guided bombs, with 2 more air-to-air missiles, which omits the need for an escort like in the case of Kargil war, where MiG-29B provided cover to Mirage 2000 when it was bombing Pakistani intruders. With this configuration, 4 Tejas can be far more deadly than the Mirages and an effective choice for light strike roles, where the threat level is low. It can perform self-escorted missions in enemy airspace and perform its role effectively. We would love to see the IAF with 3 to 4 squadrons of Tejas. Just imagine, it would be so awesome to have our indigenous fighter aircraft squadrons. That's it for today's video. Please do let us know in the comment section what new you got to know about Tejas. Thank you so much for watching the video. I'll see you in the next one.